idea is, can we find a way to use this surplus profit that's already existing to help those who really need it the most? And basically, what we thought is, well, maybe we could try and start our own bottled water company, where all of the profit funds, so it's owned 100% by a charitable trust. Now, the thing is that we were in our first year uni, we had no experience, we did not know what we were doing. All the mentors that we talked to have said, this hasn't been done before. You need to be able to, you know, have investors and have startup capital, and you don't really know what you're doing. Maybe wait till you finish uni first. Maybe wait till you have a nice nest egg behind you. But there was something in us that just could not wait. We saw these stories of children and who had spent their whole entire day going to collect water. And what that would mean is that they would leave the safety of their village to go and collect that water. There were all these different stories that we heard, and we said, we've got to be able to do something. A year into the journey, we had 350 customers around the country. Now, we lost 300 of those 350 customers, because our supplier didn't actually supply within a period of 5 weeks. We then lost a big distributor in Queensland who said, you guys are just kids, you don't know what you're doing. And see, what we were doing in amongst all this time is we're juggling our part-time jobs so that we can give our absolute all to this dream, but yet we felt like we were getting nowhere. You know, after the first year, we made about $7,000. The year after that, it was like another $7,000 and a couple of $100 more. And we're literally like, what are we doing? Why are we doing this? But this is the first point I want to leave with you today, is that we've learned that in our struggles, in life's roughest storms, they prove the strength of your anchor. You have to have some anchors. For me, one of my anchors was the reason why we're doing what we're doing. We went to Cambodia to see some of our projects for the first time. I saw this lady, and I'll never forget this moment. I said to her, how has life changed for you now that you've got access to safe water? She said, well, you know, I don't have to spend my whole entire income on medical expenses. Instead, I said, what do you do with your money instead? She said, well, instead, we bought this plow. And I'm looking at this plow like, oh, okay, a plow, great. But then it really resonated to me what this plow actually means. It means instead of her family spending their whole entire income trying to keep themselves alive, they can now spend their money to be able to invest into something like a plow, which now generates more income for their family than lifting themselves out of poverty. I saw children who were no longer sick and had to just stay at home. They can now go to school and dream of what they wanted to be for their future. This was one of our anchors. And I want to just encourage you today, whatever your anchors are, you need to make sure that you spend that time strengthening them. So when those storms hit, you've got something to pull you through those hard times.